Hi everyone, welcome you all. In our previous video, we have seen how to use different type of reporters in Playwright, like a list reporter, line reporter, and .html, JSON, and then JUnit reporters. And these are all built-in reporters provided by Playwright. So apart from this, we can also use third-party reporters. And Allure reporter is one of the popular reporter which we can use along with the Playwright. Now in the today's video, I'm going to show you how can we generate Allure reports in the Playwright. So if I look at the documentation reporter section, and if I scroll down bottom of the page, they have provided what are all third-party reporters are supported in Playwright. You can see Allure is one of the popular third-party reporter which is supported in Playwright. Now we'll see how can we use this reporter to generate Allure reports in Playwright. So if I click on this link, it will go to their official documentation. And it is a simple step-by-step process. So first we need to install a new module called Allure Playwright module. And once you have installed this module, then simply in the configuration file, Playwright configuration file, we will just add the name of the report. Okay, or then we can just run the command. So this command will generate the Allure report files. And once the files are generated, we can finally generate the HTML report based on the files. Okay. Now I will show you step-by-step process. How can we do this? Very, very simple. Now I have make all the steps. The first step, a prerequisite is we need to start installing the Allure Playwright module. So to install this, we have to run this particular command. Through node package module, we can install this command. npm i-d @playwright-test Allure-playwright. So when I execute this command, this will install Allure Playwright module. So I already installed this package on my system. You can just go to VS Code Editor. In the terminal itself, we can execute the command. In the terminal itself, we can execute this command. So I already executed this command. If I look at this, this is the same command I have executed. npm i-d playwright test Allure Playwright module. So this will install four different packages and zero vulnerabilities. So once you have installed this particular package, then once you install this particular module, then you need to go to package.json, and in the packages.json you will see one more new entry. So once you have installed Allure Playwright module in the package.json, you will see a new entry here along with the Playwright test. You will see the new entry. So if you have this entry in the package.json, that means Allure Playwright module is already present in your project. So that is the first step. Okay, so this is the first step. So once we have installed Allure Playwright module, the second thing is to run the Allure commands, we have to install a separate command line for Allure. Okay, to run the Allure commands, we have to install a separate Allure command line. So for that, we need to execute this command npm install -g Allure command line --save -dev. So for the reference, you can just look at this document. And how to install Allure command line. Okay, so to install Allure command line, you can just execute this command. So this command you have to execute through terminal, and this will automatically install Allure command line. So later we require this command line to run Allure related command. So these are the two prerequisites. Okay, and sometimes when executing this command, you will have some permission related issues. Sometimes if you do not have permissions on the particular folder, so this will throw some errors. So if you are running this command on Mac or Linux, better to run as a sudo permission, with the sudo permission. So you can say sudo npm install -g Allure command line --save -dev. So if you are working on Linux or Unix or Mac, you have to execute this command with the sudo permissions. And if you are working on Windows, you can directly execute this command as a run as an administrator and execute this command. Okay, so once you executed this command, you will have Allure command line. Okay, so these are the two prerequisites. One is we have to install Allure Playwright module through this command. Second step is what? We need to install Allure command line by running this command. Okay, once you have this, we are ready to generate the Allure reports. I will provide you all the steps in the description. You can just go through step by step. Now, so once you have environment is done, setup is done, now we will start configuring and generating the Allure reports. So directly go to the Playwright config.js. So earlier we already seen this particular file. So whatever type of reporter we want to generate, we can specify individually like this: reporter HTML, reporter JSON or JUnit. Or if you want to generate multiple reporters, we can put them in the form of arrays like this. So similarly, I'm also added one additional option here, Allure Playwright. And the output folder is optional. And if you want to specify where exactly you want to generate, you can specify the folder name here, my Allure result. So this folder will be created under the project, and inside the project, all Allure reported files will be available. So along with other reporters, I am also generating the Allure report. So this is the entry which we need to add in the playwright.config.jsl file, Allure report, comma, output folder is this one. So you can just rename this. Suppose if you want to create another folder somewhere else, you can just provide the location. So this is the first thing we need to do. Okay, once our configuration is done, so everything is ready. Now we have to just run the test. Okay, so three steps we have done. First step, we have installed Allure Playwright module. Second step, we have installed Allure command line. And third step, we have provided the reporter configuration inside the playwright.config.js file. Now we can start running the test. So I'm taking one test here, reporters.spec.js. Currently I have a three test, two test I'm passing, and third test I'm intentionally failing so that we can see the failures in the report also. So now I'm running the test. So to run the test, as usual, we have to execute this command, npx playwright test, test reporter spec.js. So this is a common normal command we will normally run to run the test. If you want to run specific browser, you can say -- project chromium. And if you want to run again in the headed mode, you can say -- headed. So currently I'm not running in headed mode. I'm just running the test. So once you run the test, now all three tests are executed. And test one, test two are passed. Now my test three is got failed. So this is a HTML report generated by the Playwright. Okay. So just ignore that. Now if I go back, so our test is got executed, and then control C, it is exited. So once your test is executed, you can just observe in our current project, there is a new folder got created called my Allure results. In the Playwright configuration, whatever the folder name, output folder name you have given with the same name, it is newly generated a folder under project my Allure result. So there are multiple files are there. We can't understand all these files. So what we have to do is, by using all these files, we have to generate the HTML file. Okay, HTML report, or that is actual Allure report, which we have to generate by using these files. Okay, so for that, what we need to do is we need to run two Allure commands. Okay, so this is the one command which will generate Allure reports. So far, we haven't generated any Allure report. Just we have run the test, and that is created a different files in the result folder. By using these files, we have to generate the Allure report. Okay. So now we have to execute the two commands. The first command to generate the Allure report, we have to execute this command, Allure generate. And this is the current folder in which all files are generated, right? Once I have executed your test, all files are generated inside this folder, my Allure result. So that we have to specify. -o representing the output directory or output folder. And folder name is what? Allure-report. So this is another folder will be created inside the project. And inside the project, inside the folder, you will see the Allure report. So to generate the Allure report, we have to execute this command. And to run this Allure related commands, we need Allure command line. Additionally, we required that we already installed at the step number one. So here, step number two, installing Allure command line, right? So we already installed it. So we can run this command directly. So we can just copy this command and go to the terminal. Let me clear this. So these files are already there, okay? Once I have executed your test, all Allure results are captured here. By using these result file, it will generate the Allure report. Now I'm just copying this command and execute. So this particular command is executed and report successfully generated to Allure report. So once I have executed this command, it is successfully generated Allure report, where we can see that report we can see in this folder, Allure-report. So in the command itself, we provided the folder. If you want to provide some other folder, you can provide, right? So now Allure report folder is got generated. Now we have to open the Allure report. These are the different files are generated. Okay, but still it is not understandable format. So we have to open the Allure report. So to open the Allure report, we have to execute one last command called Allure open Allure-report. Allure open, this is the folder. This is the folder which we have already specified in the previous command, right? So we have to open this Allure report. Allure open Allure report. So this is the command I'm executing here. Allure open Allure-report. So once you have executed, now we can see it is automatically opens the Allure report. You can see here, this is the overview window, and 66.66% is got passed and rest of them are failed. Three test cases got executed. And currently it is executed only on the Chromium browser. All three tests, one is got failed, three got passed. And you can see so many things in this, categories and suits. Okay, graphs, very beautiful and very attractive graphs you can see here. And timeline, how much time they have taken, and behaviors and different packages. So if you have more number of tests, more number of test suits, and you will see everything in the Allure report. It's very, very attractive. Okay. So this is how we can simply generate the Allure report in the Playwright test. Very simple. Only thing is we need to install Playwright Allure module. So Allure Playwright module, and install Allure command line, and then add this type of report in the configuration file and simply run the test. As soon as you run the test, Allure report files will be generated. Allure report files will be generated inside this folder, my Allure results, and where we have configured this in the config.js file. So here we configured, this is output folder. And once all files are available, then we can generate Allure report by using this another command and generate Allure report. After that, we can open the Allure report, and whenever you want, we can see the report. So these are the step-by-step process we can do to generate the Allure report. So I will provide all the steps in the description clearly, and you can just execute the sequence of commands and you will be able to generate the Allure report in Playwright. Okay. So that's all for this video. In the next video, we'll discuss another topic. Thanks for watching.